this is Joel at Storypipe. On my right is Jack, the new host of next week's debuting Storypipe Indie Film Show. And as just a token of appreciation for making other new content on Storypipe, I'm going to pass you the pen. Yes, I'm going to pass you the official news pen. Okay, but I need it back. From CNN.com, because we only steal from the best. Charlestown, Massachusetts. Two men pleaded not guilty. Can we just stop for a second and talk about the fact that when people get lazy about English, they usually like to shorten the spellings of words or go with the colloquial pronunciation like sherbert versus sherbet. But pled has gone and given way to pleaded, which is harder to spell and harder to say because it's extra syllables. I don't know why we do it. But two men pleaded not guilty Thursday to charges they created panic by placing electric light boards that caused a bomb scare Wednesday in Boston. The boards depicted a cartoon character making an obscene gesture at passing motorists. Assistant Attorney General John Grossman called the light boards bomb-like devices and said that if they had been explosive, they could have damaged transportation infrastructure in the city. Just, you know, if they had been bombs, but they weren't. They were lights. They were cartoon characters, not bombs. But if they had been bombs, they could have blown something up, but they weren't. But if they had been, it would have been bad. Of course, we're referring to Aqua Teen Hunger Force and the terrible, terrible, terrible $1 million scare that went on in Boston. Judge Paul K. Leary told Grossman that, according to the law, the suspects must intend to create a panic to be charged with placing hoax devices. Peter Berdowski and Sean Stevens were released on $2,500 bail. At a news conference after the hearing, Stevens and Berdowski stepped up to the microphones and said they were taking questions only about 1970s haircuts. Good for them. On Wednesday, Boston authorities shut down bridges and a stretch of the Charles River. The scare sparked criticism of Turner Broadcasting Systems, the parent company of CNN. Possibly late after this. Because the cartoon Moon Men were part of a guerrilla marketing campaign to promote Aqua Teen Hunger Force. I have a lot to say, but trust me, I've actually cut, you can verify this, I've cut like, yeah, tons. Berdowski and Stevens face charges of placing a hoax device in a way that results in a panic, the crime, as well as one count of disorderly conduct. The hoax charge is a felony. Boston Police Commissioner Edward Davis called the stunt unconscionable, while Boston Mayor Thomas Menino called it outrageous and the product of corporate greed. Democratic Representative Ed Markey, a Boston area congressman, added, "It would be hard to dream up a more appalling publicity stunt." Give me 5 seconds to think of something that's more appalling. How about an actual bomb threat? Turner said the devices have been placed 2 or 3 weeks ago in Boston, New York, Los Angeles, Chicago, Atlanta, Seattle, Portland, Oregon, Austin, Texas, San Francisco, California, and Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, where it didn't cause even a stir. But in Boston, state and local and federal authorities on Wednesday shut down the Boston University and Longfellow bridges and blocked maritime traffic from across the Charles River into Boston Harbor. Bomb squads scrambled throughout the city and suburbs, snarling traffic and mass transit in the city. It had a very sinister appearance. It had a battery behind it and wires, just like a radio. Okay,